Hey, hey, this is Dr. Nashlie Sephus, and I'm a principal AI scientist at Amazon Web Services. I specialize in responsible AI, and today we're gonna talk to Alicia, Mia, as well as Valeria, who work on the responsible AI team, about the work that they've done, and we're gonna show you how you can get more involved as well. You were a part of a tutorial for the FACT conference, and so I want you to tell us a little bit more about that tutorial and what you did there.
We wanted to present some information to the community about how generative AI has changed the landscape of responsible AI. So here you can see an example of what a large language model does. It's just going to choose the next most likely word. Given that we have students in the context, the model is guided more towards books as the most likely completion, followed by laptops. And what's really amazing about this is you can now add books to the context and you can generate another word and another until you have a phrase, a sentence, a novel. If you were to compare this to a more traditional AI model for something like consumer lending, we're gonna look at a training set of loan applications where we know the truth, whether the applicant did or did not pay back the loan. And we're gonna train a model to make binary decisions, yes or no, given a new application, do we think that this new applicant is likely to default? So a model that can spit out ones and zeros in response to a very structured input of a loan application, that can still go wrong. And we've seen it go wrong if it doesn't approve loans from certain communities at the same rate that it does in other communities. We have algorithmic solutions to make those types of decisions more fair. When we think about a generative model like the one you just saw, it's newer and it's more nuanced to try to even define what fairness means there.
For example, if someone applies for a loan and they're denied, they're going to want to know why. But if the institution can't explain, so we're lacking explainability, then that's a problem. Could you talk a little more about how you classify those things that could go wrong and what can we do about it?
We think about genders, we think about ethnicities, experiences of people in different geographies. Context and the organizational context where you're making these RAI decisions has a big effect. And a lot of it does have to do with what you just mentioned, like what can go wrong and who is harmed in the process.
It boils down to context. And really understanding your use case so that you can better tell, is this a risk, a higher risk, a lower risk?
And there are actions that we can take to mitigate the risk at a variety of stages of development of the model. We can investigate our data. Is our data representative of all the customers we expect to use it? And then your algorithm. If you do have even a small amount of underrepresentation or bias in your data set, is your algorithm amplifying that bias? We can measure bias at every training iteration so that we're optimizing not only for accuracy, but also for the distribution of accuracy across different groups. Part of the solution is also making sure you use these AI tools in the context of a workflow that includes humans that are also applying their own judgment.